today I'm going to build a chicken incubator. The total cost for this was under $40. Everything on the table was $38.48, and it basically included two stops, although I had made a third stop and picked up the cooler itself at the dollar store. So the cooler, as you can see, was $2.50. But I picked these two items at Home Depot, and it's just a sponge and some hardware cloth. And the other items I picked up were a socket adapter for a light bulb, an extension cord, some duct tape, a picture frame so we can create a window on top, a thermometer with humidity, and two different types of light bulbs so we can test the different temperatures. Obviously, if you have some of this, you can save yourself some money, but I just wanted to make sure that if you didn't have anything, you knew that it was about 40 bucks. And of course, you gotta buy it in the four pack. You can't, unfortunately, just buy one. Now, they don't make incandescent bulbs that I could find at either Walmart or Home Depot. So what I did was got these halogen ones, and hopefully these get warm enough to make a difference. And I got the two different wattages, because what we're trying to do is keep everything warm inside the incubator when we make it. So you can get these at Walmart, but again, I just happened to be at the dollar store and saw it, so I picked it up there. But basically what we're going to do is we're going to cut some of this hardware cloth, and we're going to make a shelf that sits in the bottom. It's going to sit down there so that the eggs have something to sit on that aren't sitting on the bottom. We're going to use a sponge. We're going to wet it, and that's going to help us to control our humidity. And obviously, we're going to track our humidity and temperature with this. This is going to help us to seal up the window, because we're going to take the glass out of this picture frame and put it in the top. That'll help us seal up the window. This is how we're going to plug in the light bulb. And obviously, this is how we're going to get it, so it doesn't have to be up against the wall to be plugged in. So, okay, let's start building this. So I'm going to try to do this one-handed, and we'll see how this works. Make sure my utility knife is all the way out. That's a styrofoam. It's cutting pretty easy. One thing I want to be really careful I do is don't push too hard and break through. But it seems to be cutting okay. That one's cut through. That's cut through. So let's come down here to this one and cut this. Okay. Now we're gonna cut through on this. Seems to help if you do a little bit of a sawing action as you're pulling it along. That's all the way through, and that is. That's all the way through. So we should be able to just cut along this one now. So it's not all the way through, but I can see it on this side. So what I'm going to do is just kind of trace my cut if I can. Yeah, we're going to do it from this side. It's just falling along through, making sure the knife's plunged all the way in as I'm doing it. That's much better. Now I can tell that's loose. Probably just need to do the same thing over here. Done. So
We cut out the window hole. Probably put some tape over this just to make sure that all these little fuzzies don't come off and into the chicken brooder. The last thing you want to do is have a chick eat all those. Essentially, there's our hole. So now the one thing we probably still have to do is this is slightly raised. So it's kind of nice on this one because it's raised. I probably just have to cut some of this away here. Like so. And that window might sit in there real nice. That worked out pretty good there. Same thing on this side. Might actually do this first. Just try not to cut too far down, because we don't kind of cut through. We just want to cut into. I'm gonna do the same thing here. Just kind of slide the knife in as deep as we need it to go, which isn't very deep. Side. So now we kind of had to do the same thing along these longer edges, which could prove to be difficult, but let's see. I'm just going to go in just a little ways. Just like this. I'm going to make sure we go all the way. Okay, we'll do the same thing on this side. Again, we're not cutting all the way through. We're just cutting essentially the thickness of the glass. Let's do that on ends. Okay, so now, if we do this right, we should just be able to kind of run. Of course, it's styrofoam, so it makes a nice mess. The knife blade kind of along the edge here, like this. Create our lip that's flush with the glass. Cool. See, there's still a little bit of a lip there, which is what we wanted. So let's do it on this side now. And just like that, we're done. So let's test, let's look and see if our glass fits in there like we hope it does. Perfect. So there's our glass. So what I'm gonna do is just put some duct tape around that, and that's gonna require two hands. So I'm gonna set the camera down and we'll tape it up. Okay, so here's the finished product. I put a layer of tape down on the edges and then folded it under like that. And then I set the glass in on top of that tape, and then I just used some duct tape to kind of seal it. So now that glass isn't gonna fall out of there, which is what we want. So for the next part, you can see I got some marker on this. It's not a big deal. I held up the adapter where I want it to go, and I traced around it. So the one thing we want to make sure we do is that this is actually has a lip on it. So you can see it's a little bit bigger on the lip. And when we traced around it, that's even bigger. So when we cut this hole, we want to make sure that we actually cut inside of this and not on the line. So if you cut on the line, you're going to have a problem of this just falling through. You want this to be a very tight fit. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to cut inside by about, oh, maybe a quarter of an inch. And I'd rather make sure that I have to push this in, and actually it'll push in this way. But I want this to be a very tight fit. So when you trace around it to get your general idea of where you're going to go, just make sure you cut about a quarter inch all the way around. On the inside. You want it to be, a very tight fit. So I'm going to go ahead and turn the video off, cut that out, and push this in. We'll see how it works. So I cut the hole, and as you can see, it's smaller than this is, which is what we want. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to push this in from this side, and it should be a nice tight fit. And that's what we want. We want it to be a really tight fit. Not a tight fit, had potential to fall out. So it's got twisted a little bit, and look at that, very tight fit. Hope, just like we were hoping for. So I'm just gonna keep wiggling it on through. And there you go. Now, it's super tight, and that's what we wanted. So we've got a very tight fit on our plug. And we'll be able to plug this in, and that's where our light bulb's gonna go in to heat up the inside of our incubator. Here's how I'm gonna measure how big I need to cut this wire. I'm just gonna set the incubator, or the cooler, on top of the mesh. Leave myself about three of these little squares, which should be 3/4 of an inch, because after all, this is 1/4 inch hardware cloth. And just trace around it. So I'm just going to trace this side, or kind of mark how many three little dots are, and same thing on that end, and then cut it out. And we'll see how that works. Some of you might be wondering, why did I cut that long? And so I could do this. So after I knew it was cut to the right size and longer than what I needed, I was able to cut through the corners at a 45 degree angle. And once I got through the 45 degree angle, then I was able to bend it up. And what this does is it's going to create me a little platform for everybody to sit on. So when it sits in there like this, it'll sit off the bottom. And the reason we want it to sit up off the bottom is so that when the chicks hatch, if they need to poop or anything like that, it just falls down through and they're not standing in it. So just an easy cleanup kind of thing. One last thing before we end this video. And I was trying to think to myself, what's a good way to keep those eggs stable? And actually, I was thinking about it, and why not just an egg carton? So I don't know as if the bottom of the egg carton is right, because when we have an egg, what we don't want to do is have the egg sitting up and down. We kind of want it to be laying on its side like this. At least that's the ones that I've seen. So I'm going to use the top, and I just cut the top off. And I think that'll be perfect for putting our eggs inside of the incubator. And as you can see, it's been about 10 minutes, if that. And we've leveled out at about 99 degrees, which is just where we want to be, and 54% humidity. Now there's 100. That's even better than 99. But you see, we've gone down actually in humidity. So what I do need to do is add some more water to that sponge. And obviously you can control the humidity by either adding or removing water from the sponge. And if it does start to get a little bit too hot in here, now that we've hit 100 degrees, which is kind of our optimum or ideal temperature, what we'll do is we'll just poke a couple of holes again, up here or on the side or somewhere, to help give it a little bit of a vent. And we'll just do those one at a time until we hit the right temperature.